أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمد ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم. Dear respected uncle, auntie, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. If my friend at school pushes me during recess, what should I do? If my younger brother spills juice on my favorite shirt, what should I do? If my neighbor's dog accidentally my garden's flowers, what should I do? What our beautiful religion teaches us is that in each of these cases, I must forgive. Forgive, forgive, and forgive. Forgiveness is the body is from the current present to today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most kind and the most merciful. We are all in need of forgiveness. To receive this forgiveness, however, we must not look at others. When we forgive Allah's creation, then there are more chances that Allah Almighty will forgive us. Forgiveness is from two types of sins, major and minor. For minor sins, we can simply say Astaghfirullah and hope on that our merciful Lord to forgive us. Even by saying Durood Sharif, our minor sins can be erased. And for each Durood Sharif recited, Subhanallah. However, for major sins such as lying, backbiting, and the like, we must make tawbah to Allah in addition to seeking forgiveness. There are three basic requirements for making tawbah. Number one, recognizing the offense itself and admission before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, making a commitment not to repeat the offense. Number three, asking for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the offense is committed against another human being or against society, that does not forgive us until that person has forgiven us. Subhanallah. Such are the rules of our beautiful religion. Muslims are taught many phrases and many words to keep repeating daily, asking Allah forgiveness. For example, Astaghfirullah, I ask forgiveness from Allah. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Glory be to Allah. And with your praise, I have your witness that there is no deity but you. I ask for forgiveness and I return to your obedience. Here I would like to speak a beautiful hadith about forgiveness. The Prophet, peace be upon him, was the most forgiving person. He was ever ready to forgive his enemies. When he went